Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the second inaugural Yogscast Capture the Wool. I am your host, Lewis, a very experienced veteran of Minecraft, joined by the creator, leader of the Bleb community who helped make Capture the Wool, Barry.
How's
welcome
it going?
Back for the second of this exciting tournament. I'm very excited. They've already started. We can see the blue team.
I know, they're already away.
We're already advancing. So we've got a new couple of teams. We've got some new classes that we haven't seen before.
It's going to be exciting, Lewis. I'm super excited to see how the guys deal with it today.
Yeah.
I can't believe they're already making progress. They don't even give us a moment to introduce them, do they?
They don't need it.
I love
it. So we got Boba, Bree, Martin Littlewood, and OC.
Yeah, this is on the blue team.
Blue.
This is a good team, Lewis. I feel like this is an impactful team. They've all played a lot of Capture the Wool, and Martin, I would say, is probably one of the best. He's got to be one of the best Minecraft players in Yogscast, right? They've already opened a dungeon. They're already there.
We've actually got some really high level, considerably. I mean, oh my god, Boba just knocked.
Oh, whoops! I didn't see you.
Kill him with kindness. Kill him with kindness.
I love it. I love it. Instantly. You're making friends, you know. You've got to make friends in Minecraft.
And the red team is Ben, Mango, but they are supported by Pedgwin and Ravs.
I know. We saw such a strong performance last time out of Pedgwin, didn't we?
I mean, Pedgwin and Ravs, I would say, are the two top players, but Mango and Ben are probably the two weakest players.
They're very new to this game, but they're still learning it and discovering it.
They're inexperienced, that's all.
So what do I actually do? Like, I know I lay a bomb when I die, but do I do other stuff too?
Ben is a hero. He's a support. He's a great supporter.
He is.
He's always there for you. He's always got your back. He's willing to. He's selfless. He's caring.
There's something to be said for just having, you know, positivity on the team, because, you know, it can get quite stressful at moments, and having people who are cool, calm, and collected. And a level head.
I'd say Ben was a blue personality. He's placid, he's thoughtful, he's caring.
Which is kind of, you know, the opposite of what class he's playing today. he's kind of playing one of the most trolly obnoxious classes we have in the game mode. Ben's playing, it looks like Bomberman, it's called the Grenadier.
Bomberman. Bomberman, yes, it's the Grenadier. So Grenadier explodes when he dies.
He drops a TNT when he dies to a PvP death, which is absolutely terrifying.
It's very stressful to deal with, that's right.
And it's also worth noting, he also, when he plants TNT, he instantly ignites it. So he doesn't need to flint or steal it or set it on fire or anything. He just instantly ignites the TNT.
Yes.
Which means that he can just blow people up so easily. But his inventory is filled with all this gunpowder everywhere, so he's going to have a bit of a horrible
time
managing around that.
It's a bit of a ball ache playing Grenadier. And also, you can't get TNT until... I think the golden dungeon, right?
That's correct, yes. And it's quite expensive. It's not so cheap to buy. It's about 20 coins for only a couple TNT. So they're going to need to work as a team to probably feed Ben a lot of money so that he can do his TNT plays.
Yes, that's a good idea.
So how are they progressing? Blue are like already storming headless.
I feel like the layout here is really different. Have they altered like the pathing here?
Blue have already made progress into their dungeon. Yeah, they've already cracked in and they're killing stuff. They're fighting their way through. So we've got Martin playing as the...
This is the Explorer. It used to be called the Miner. This is the Explorer now. Because it felt like, you know, it wasn't... The Miner never really did much mining. They kind of did a lot more dungeon exploring. So it's been renamed. And it's pretty much the same as last time. Just some resistance, some tankiness, and some mining speed increases.
Oh, he's about to get eaten by this zombie though.
He's
survived on one heart. Martin, you hero. Oh, yeah, and he's killing spawners. Look at him there, using his mining speed to kill that spawner, clearing out the dungeon very efficiently. Bree here is the berserker.
Oh my god. I just got to say, Lewis, I think the berserker hat is probably my favorite.
Isn't it gorgeous?
Just the little bear hat is so cute.
Yeah,
I love it so much. It's Bree making some iron armor. Good play
and
by
here
Bree.
Comes Ozzy. She's the plague doctor.
Yes. Man, I love that we're seeing some new classes. I wonder how we'll see them utilize them.
So, sorry, the berserker is higher damage the more you're injured.
That's correct.
At lower health, you get a damage buff and... I think another buff.
You get a resistance buff as well, so you take less damage. So you can kind of juggle this low HP balance, but at full HP, you attack a lot slower. So it's kind of this class where you weirdly want to get hurt. It's it requires a bit of skill and a bit of thought to play, but I think Bree's probably got that unlocked. So.
It has good power in one-on-ones, that's for sure.
Yeah, like it's very scary. You get strength 2 when you drop down to low HP, and strength 2 in Minecraft is 6 extra damage per hit.
Yeah,
so I don't
very
know.
Very strong.
I wonder how we'll see Bree use it. You know, is he not going to be
already taking advantage of it. Look at him. He's just 3 hearts, just killing his way through this dungeon.
I love it.
Edging it.
He's right. He's an edgelord, old Bree, I would call him.
He's really edging hard.
Yeah. Look at him. He's already wearing full iron armor. He's got a shield. He knows what he's doing. Let's check on Red, see how they're doing.
There's some chests down there that I didn't pick up, so if you can make sure to grab a couple of loots.
These are like the most important chests in the game because they're like Ackermans and stuff.
Yeah.
Well, not the most important chests in the game, but they're pretty nutty.
They're making some way into their dungeon. They certainly had a slower start though, Lewis. I don't feel as good about this for them.
Yeah,
they're
a little bit slower, but don't you ever underestimate Pedgwin and Revs. The power of those two is very scary.
It's got to be said, Pedgwin is also playing, I would say, arguably one of the strongest classes in the game. He's playing this messenger classless. He gets double run speed and double jump height, which is crazy. It's so good at dungeoneering. It's so good in PvP. You can literally just run away from people and they can't catch you.
Well, wool carrying as well. Very effective. Look at him dashing everywhere through this dungeon. He's poisoned at the moment, but he's just dashing through, avoiding stuff, I assume. His strategy is going to be to avoid monsters, avoid spawners, get through the dungeon, and get to key locations. Maybe if you're attacking your opponent's dungeon, steal their stuff.
Yeah.
And then, of course, carrying the wool back, huge advantage if you can move extra speed.
It is worth noting, though, that the negative on the messenger is pretty harsh because you get some really good traits. So the negative is you lose over half your inventory to parcels and letters that you're carrying, which means that Pedgwin won't be able to carry his spare loot for his team. He's going to have to be careful what items he's keeping on him, and it's just a lot more inventory management.
And it makes him a lot worse at stealing other people's dungeon loot because... Yeah. Inventory space is always at such a premium in this. You know, you go into their dungeon, you take like you open a bunch of iron chest armor, and you can't carry any of it. And so, yeah, it's actually not very effective as a harassment kind of class.
Look, this seems accelerating so quickly. Blue team are already on this iron golem room. I can't believe it. Like they're going so quick.
Well, they're experienced, but not that experienced.
I think Bree was trying to bait the low HP for the bonus damage, but got a little bit too close. He got a little bit greedy.
So Ozzy picked the Plague Doctor.
This is a really interesting class. I don't think I've ever seen Ozzy play it. She's played this game mode quite a lot. So Plague Doctor, they have a AoE clear for poison and wither. So they heal their team of poison and wither in an AoE around them and themselves.
It's a very good support class.
So nice to just have a Plague Doctor sat next to you against these poison spiders and, you know...
My God. And I assume that Ozzy was thinking this is a counter to the ranger. I don't know if they have if we actually have a ranger on the other team. We don't.
But actually, you know what, Lewis? I love this as a tactical pick because on their side, the blue side's gold dungeon is the mushroom area, which is filled with these witches that throw poison potions at you. So I think they're hoping to send Ozzy into that dungeon and just let her really dominate. I love this from Ozzy. I think this is a good pick.
Also, it kind of, if you've got a Plague Doctor on your team, because now the range has been changed, so they have always got poison arrows.
Yeah, and you can also
pick a Plague Doctor. It's very powerful to just take, because poison arrows are cheap. They're available from the first shop, and usually everyone has a stack of
poison arrows. They're so good. They're so
strong. Arrows. It means that OC can just negate like this huge amount of team damage over the course of the battle and stop a ranger pick.
Yeah, I also just cave spiders. Cave spiders really suck. Like we saw it last time, people really get punished by cave spiders. That extra poison tick, it's just really annoying. And you take so much extra damage, you use so much more food. So all around a good pick, but she does get less HP. So I wonder if the team are going to buy her some more HP, try and, you know, buff her up, because that less HP on someone is really painful.
Look at this. She's just been chipping down these iron golems while her team run back. But
it's great play. She's done amazingly here.
Martin's
going to
come
impressed
in and probably get himself clobbered.
He's safe spotting well. I'm super impressed by this. This is a pretty clean iron golem room, even though a couple of them died.
Yeah, well, you're bound to lose a couple people because it's kind of, it catches you by surprise. Yeah, really.
The damage they deal is insane. But OC, honestly, a hero, just slowly chipping them down with that crossbow.
And then the final member of the blue team is Boba, playing as a sort of zombie cleric.
Yeah.
It kind of goes well with her skin, actually, the goblin kind of. It looks like she's some sort of undead necromancer cleric, but...
I really love the cleric hat. It's really cute.
So the cleric actually has its first two hotbar slots blocked by a book and a flagellation lead.
Yeah, well put. That's
which is quite annoying, but actually, when you the way the cleric works is whenever you hit a friendly friend,
yeah,
they get healed.
Yeah, they get instantly applied. I think it's 4 hearts or 3 hearts, so it's quite a substantial amount of healing that you can do.
It's the first proper healer in, well, if the loot boy is kind of a regen, regen, the cleric is a more targeted healer.
The thing is, you can just spam click on people and basically just accelerate them up to full HP. So yeah. I wonder if, you know, we're going to see Boba maybe sit behind Martin or Bree, one of these more aggressive players. Because that kind of combination of with Bree wanting to get to low HP and Boba be able to bring him back up, I think there's a play there.
It makes for your team to be able to be more aggressive, but you do have to fight together. Mm. And you have to, you know, there is a thing of this, of if you've got 2v1, you know, the overwhelming nature of 2v1 usually wins you that battle. But with the cleric on the side, they're more likely to just say, well, you're not going to kill either of us.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna stay back and heal my friend, and you're not going to be able to do anything.
So I hope she puts it to good use, because it's easy to forget that you have that ability, you know, and just start playing Minecraft. But if she can put it to good use, I think it will be really impactful.
There you go. She's already doing it, just casually punching Bree. So,
Lewis, I think we're seeing a completely wild play from Red Team. Red Team are in their shulker room, but Ped's got the key, and he's already going over to the gold dungeon. He's opening the gold dungeon early.
Oh, wow.
So this is, we're going to see a gold dungeon be open before any wool has been reclaimed.
I've already got the key, yeah. I think I'm just going to head straight to the gold dungeon.
Well, there's quite a lot of work, because the monsters on this gold dungeon, even outside, are a lot tougher. Mm. And so he's going to have to either just nerd pole over them all, which it looks like is exactly what he's doing. He's just going to ignore all the pigmen on this dungeon, this island.
The trouble is, he's now, you know, the team is going to be very split, because they're going to need people to, you know, defend and hold this gold dungeon and also loot it. And the other team are about to get a notification that this is going in.
Well, they might not notice.
They
for
might,
a start.
True.
And
actually, Lewis, oh my God, he might just put it in the lock and not open the door.
Well, we'll see. But you know, you can get a big old bonus if you can get in there, grab a couple of the early chests.
Yeah.
And it's because he's actually wearing, I think, a leather chest plate.
Yeah, it's not looking good. He's doing it. He's just opened. We've seen a gold dungeon be. I mean, the game is moving at such a pace. This is crazy.
You're low.
They've been slain by Vex, so they are ahead of us.
They're doing their boss.
Oh, wow. Yeah, look, they've opened their gold.
He's down. It's fine.
The beasts are spicy in there.
We're good.
Yeah, we've got our key. Osi's going to path over, and I'm just going to quickly restock, and I'm on the way.
I'll go get the wool. Can you make sure I've got a path to the Monument Island, Boba?
Yeah, I can do that.
Oh my God, they speed did it. We missed the game is moving so quickly. We missed it.
He's got in. So in fact, that puts a timer on the other team's gold dungeon opening.
It's 15 minutes. You get 15 minutes to get your key in the lock, and then if not, it opens automatically. But it looks like the blue team are already working over. I this is such an interesting playlist. Both teams are kind of ignoring the whirl. They're going for the dungeon. I think they think the acceleration and loot you get from gold dungeon, maybe they value that quite highly.
Well, but they've been coming up with a lot of these strategies, talking amongst themselves. Mm. And we gave them a little bit of time before this game started to think amongst themselves and come up with some ideas. So
yeah.
Oh my God, I love these slimes that Ozzy and Martin are fighting.
The boingies.
Yeah.
The big smiley faces. They're so dumb, aren't they?
So they're clearing off their gold dungeon island as well. So it looks like they're not going for the disruption. They're just going to clear their mushroom island.
My concern is, Lewis, Ped's the messenger. This is like the perfect class to dive deep into a dungeon. Sure, he can't grab all the loot, but look at him. He's already so deep, and he's just removing the spawners.
Well, meanwhile, Ravs and Mango. Mango's playing the knight, by the way. We didn't mention that. So extra hit points.
Okay. Yep. It's got a new helmet. It's got a new helmet.
New helmet. They're about to go into the boss room.
Yeah, they're about to do the Lawberry boss, which I think they'll have a good time with. Ravs is pretty experienced. I'm sure he can guide Mango through this. So these are collect some books, put them in the fire, and then they can activate Brian and get chopping.
Well, let's go monument now. We need to go monument now.
Okay.
Oh, wait. Have they got the wool?
Well, I have.
Oh, you have. Oh, yeah. Cool. Yeah, obviously, let's push to mid then from where we are.
I'm concerned, Lewis. The players are spread all around the map pretty far, and I don't know if the teams are ready. It looks like Blue Team are actually going to have a really good four-man push on this Monument Island.
Well, I mean, Ravs and Mango are completely distracted fighting Brian the Librarian.
Yeah, and they're locked
they've nearly
right
got him dead, though. He's at about 40% health so far.
And you know what Martin's done? He's sneakily
down.
Put,
nice.
Martin's put the key in the lock, Lewis, so if he dies on this defense, they've still got the key in the gold dungeon lock, and they can open it anytime they want. So I like this from Martin. Good play. Let's secure the wall. Let's then open our gold dungeon and, you know, move as a team.
It's good, actually, because they're going to place the wall first and then have the ability to defend it.
Yeah.
Because Ravs and Mango are going to grab their wall now. Ravs about to take it. There you go.
Yeah.
And then Mango dies deliberately, I guess.
I actually think that's good, to speed
to the exit.
But this Bree's here. Bree's on the transition island coming over with the wall. Like, they've got a perfect bit of infrastructure built over this transition island. I don't know. I don't see any red players stopping this right now. Pet's vaguely moving towards it. Pet's already got a diamond chest plate on.
Oh, they're heading onto Monument right now.
It looks like their wheels are about to go into the elevator in a minute.
Oh my god, really? Whoa. Why are they so fast?
All right, I'm climbing the ladder. I'm climbing Monument.
I'm holding back Pet if I can. Nice, got him. He's dead.
It's just like 10 seconds ago you told me they were going, and now they're there. It's like, ah.
We didn't check the chat.
Wow, yeah. So Ped was trying to run over as messenger fast to, like, contest this wall, but Martin just defended it really solidly.
Yeah.
This might just be a very free wall, I think.
Nice. Well done, Bree. Oh, yeah.
That was pretty solo.
Well, I mean, blue team takes an early lead. There you go. That's the first wall. That's the green wall placed for blues. And reds are... behind, but ahead.
Yeah, they've made more progress on their gold dungeon, but they still have to get this wall capture that Ravs is carrying, and I don't know. I feel like the blue team have got a good chokehold on the Monument Island.
Yeah, Ped's obviously died again, and he's going to respawn. We got Ben coming in as the Grenadier. Hopefully he'll be able to have some TNT soon.
Yeah, hopefully this team can feed him some TNT.
It looks like the wall carrier's heading back home. So it looks like Ravs is taking the wall back to base to just re-equip.
You know what he might be doing?
Buy some things in the shop.
Ped might have given him some armor. There might be some armor here, some diamond armor, some protection armor that he can throw on and be a bit more tanked up. I think that's probably what they're doing. Or he's getting a better sword. He only gets 60 seconds in this base, though. He doesn't get long, so they need to move quickly. And Blue is still defending this island. They haven't opened their swamp yet, even though they have the key in it.
Well, I think they feel like there's a little bit of the feeling that we're here already, so we might as well do a little defense, knock them back, force them to spend 5 minutes recollecting their wool if they can.
Yeah, I mean, that would be really, really impactful.
Because they could always wait for that gold dungeon to time open, but man, it's a long way away.
Ped's on the island,
it's still
though.
10 minutes before it could
look
open.
Look at Ped, just got so much better gear. Spike early is so strong.
Here we go. This is what I was talking about. This is what he wanted to do. He wanted to get in there and just harass him. And fuck. Look at that.
Look at that.
See ya. Kill him,
Martin off.
Yeah.
But they need Ravs to come now, and he is. Yeah, they built a highway. This. Honestly, I didn't think the red team were going to be able to do this. I didn't think they were able to capture
that. Well, it was a 2v2 with Ped and better gear, supported from a bit of air support from Ben. And look at that. They just took Monument Island straight off of them.
The blue team are coming back, though. They're not happy. But OC's got this negative HP loss. She's not great in these just straight up fights. It doesn't feel really good. She's not really a straight-up combat, you know, class. I want her in the dungeon. I want her in the gold dungeon making work, but...
Well, I think they didn't realise. They thought they could hold it, but they're trickling in, and this is not the way to do it, really.
No, you need to be attacking as a team.
Ravs is already halfway up the escalator, but...
Bree,
we have got
Bree
a threat.
Bree sneaking. No one's stopping
sneaking
Bree.
And shooting.
Oh, I got arrowed from behind. There's someone on the left with me.
Ravs needs to be careful. This is full damage.
Oh,
height.
But he knocks...
He's free HP.
Oh, my God. He got Bree anyway. He's big shot, though.
He's being shot by Boba.
Two. Boba, these shots coming in. They're all hitting, it's amazing, but unfortunately, every single shot is hitting, but unfortunately, Rav's got the shield up, sees it coming.
Shield towards Boba, just shield towards Boba.
Yeah, I'm shielding towards Boba.
Free HP is not what you want to be in the elevator.
Boba's got that. She got like 3 or 4 arrows on target, but it sucks to not get that through. Wow. There you go. Yellow wool placed by the dark, dark pink team. Well, so look at that. It's a 1-1 tie already. And that was some pretty quick moves.
I think the red team have got to be pretty happy with that, right? That sets them quite comfortably ahead. And if they hadn't returned that wool, it could have ended in a disaster. You know, the blue team could have gone aggressive. They could have sniped that wool. Or they could have just made them take forever bringing it back. I think they've got to be pretty happy with themselves about that.
Okay, I've got a set of protection armor for myself now.
Where are the chests? Oh, I'll get spawners first as well. Nice. I'm just going to grab all the loot that's available.
Oh, that vindicator turned to me real quick.
Oh, boy.
So everyone head to, like, gold dungeon now. It's pretty clear. We should be super safe. Just need someone with, like, ladders to help with my...
I got ladders.
I'm not going to stake the sticky shoes, so they're in the leftmost chest. They're on the bottom right. I'd recommend one of you two taking... Ped, probably take them.
I'll grab them later.
Blue team and red team are making progress in their gold dungeons, so this is happening.
Yeah, I'm concerned, though. Ped's made so much progress. He's already destroyed most of the spawners, and that means his team is going to have a pretty easy time to follow behind him. He hasn't opened this shortcut, though, so he hasn't made it that deep. He's made it relatively deep, but not that deep.
Yeah. Bree just got killed by Vindicator. Blue have got a little bit of catch-up to do, but Blue did more effort cleaning off their Mushroom Island, whereas Pedquin just sort of skipped the spawners on that island. That's a kind of defensive play, but it will hurt them in the long run if they don't clear this island off.
I like that we have two red players, you know. It looks like we've got Ben and Mango just kind of, like, chilling out. Kind of looks like they're maybe just holding Monument Island, maybe looking to go aggressive. I mean, just know what their forts are.
I am blind. Where the heck is this gold tower?
God, those Vindicators are shredding today. I think he tapped me 3 times and I died with full iron on, with enchants as well.
Vindicator hurts, right?
Right, we've got to start pushing upwards because they're ahead of us on the ascent at the minute.
Yeah.
Oh, Pedgwin, well played. Pedgwin's just walking through this dungeon. He knows exactly where the spawners are. He's taking them out as he goes. He's even taken out the pufferfish ones for his team. Look at this.
I like that. That's team play right there, Liz.
That is a real noble choice.
It's worth mentioning I don't think he's checking these chests because he doesn't have much loot. Or he's probably being very selective in what he's taking.
Yeah, look, he's leaving an iron axe there and
hopefully he's calling that out to his team, you know, communicating, I'm leaving loot, make sure you check chests on the way through because I'm not grabbing everything.
Yeah, it's an interesting choice, and he's making much more headway than the blue team are, who are really still stuck at ground level.
Yeah, and the blue team have this really hard room list. This witch's face room is by far the hardest room in the entirety of the gold dungeon. You have to make this kind of vertical assault into witches and vindicators. So it all comes down to whether they can remove this vindicator spawner, because the witches for them won't be a problem. But if they don't, this could really cause some massive delays
They've got the full team. They've got OC.
And they've got Boba as well. Boba sitting behind people, keeping them healed. You know, she's just smacking Bree. You love to see it.
Yeah, I mean, they've got 2 support classes. It means that Bree can be free to just be quite reckless.
Yeah.
Or at least take more risks and have a lot less downtime as well. Right? Because actually, eating and slowly forcing your health bar back up manually is really slow.
Quite a lot of waiting. Someone needs to get the spawner. Oh, she's going for it. Oh, she's doing the Nurple. Look at that strategy from OC. Oh, it doesn't pay off, though.
Oh, and Bree dies, too.
Oh, if OC just hadn't got hit
there. And Boba's dead, too. Oh, no.
The top of that wall is hard.
Oh, there's like 70. Oh, my God. There's 70 Vindicators up there. Is anyone in our dungeon right now? No. Okay, cool.
No. So they all should despawn now.
They should despawn. Yeah, that was the problem.
Okay, Ben's going to ruin our whole architecture, and
Ben was coming in trying to do some TNT and drop some bombs.
Look at that smiley little face.
But he can't place the TNT. He can't.
He gets a little TNT off of Bree. So Monument Island is TNT protected, so he can't place the TNT, but he can drop his Martyrdom, but it doesn't blow up stuff, because obviously, you know, it would end up in a lot of griefing. So I want to see Ben get more aggressive, get over to their gold dungeon, start blowing up
bridges.
I think
that's what he was doing, but I think Bree saw him, and yeah, because Bree had died, he saw how close Ben was and thought he's just going to intercept him.
Yeah, and set him back.
And exactly.
It does look like that's what they've Ravs and Pedgwin have tasked Mango and Ben with doing. Just go be annoying. Just, you know, go run at them. Go and slow them down. You know, we'll handle the dungeons. You guys just run into.
I want to see that. I want to see that from the Grenadier, because I want, you know, that him to run by the spawn, destroy their bridges, and mm-hmm. just delay, because, you know, everyone always builds these crappy one thing bridges.
Oh yeah, you can just mine them out and just, you know, being real annoying.
If you've got 2 pieces of TNT, you just run over them, place TNT on both.
Yep.
And then, you know, it's 20 seconds of rebuilding for that team.
It's so painful. Know,
for you, it's much quicker. So it's like,
yeah, I really hope Ben puts this to work. And listen, that is his objective. So
it's so annoying to have every time you come out of your spawn, your bridge has been blown up again.
Also, it can be game winning. You know, if he destroys these bridges connecting the Gold Island to Monument Island, that could stop them bringing a wall back. It's really hard to build bridges when people are shooting you with arrows. So removing that bridge, honestly, I'd love to see him.
Well, there's a way to pin people, because mm-hmm. if you've destroyed their bridge, then they're trying to build it.
Look at him.
You know, you can just pin them in place.
He's TNT in the bridge. Goodbye, bridge. And it's glass. There's no blast resistance. It's just going to get destroyed. He's so annoying. I love it. And look, he's just gleefully wandering in, TNT in hand. He's having a great time.
Yeah, if he can blow out all of this area, that's very annoying.
Look at him. There we go. Little bridge there, little bit there, TNT here, TNT there.
that's so frustrating for them, because, you know, they have to rebuild that whole thing, and the stairway is a pain in the ass. But yeah, I like, once I said, because the way to build bridges is to walk backwards slowly, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. you really put yourself in a vulnerable position, and you if you're on your own, you often can't build a bridge into someone else, right?
Yeah, it's very hard.
If you take out their bridge, you don't have to be the Grenadier to do it, but it helps. Look at this, just taking out these things.
This is all the respawn routes that they've been using, Lewis, and they so dearly need. God, Ben is being a real annoyance. I love it.
That's Ben behind us, by the way, blowing shit up.
Yeah, don't open the shortcut until we're past this area, I think.
You know what? I'm just going to go get Ben.
Someone's coming to deal with him. Bree said, I've had enough. I've had enough, Ben. But actually, you need to be careful of this martyrdom. Bree? Oh my God, 1 HP!
Wow. And look at that mess that's been caused. Now they have to ascend up that water instead.
Oh, God. Ben,
which actually is quite annoying.
It's pretty annoying. How's Pedgwin doing? Looks like Pedgwin. Oh my God, Lewis, they're already on the top layer. He's already moving over to this double chest. This
well, this was the advantage
loot.
That they took, remember?
Yeah, they're so far ahead.
They got a couple of rooms ahead, and now blue team have been distracted because Martin had, because Bree left, you know, that left them with only one real damage dealer.
Yeah.
You know?
And equally, it looks like Ravs is actually going for this diamond key. They kind of got Ped on the upper level and Ravs on the bottom level. And Ped with this messenger, I'm pretty confident with him against Captain Gok. I think he's going to have a pretty nice time.
I'm scared of the Pedwin-Ravs combo. I called it at the start. I would not like to play against that team.
Would you not? Would you be shaken? I don't know. I think you're underestimating how good Bree and Martin are. Bree and Martin are really, really talented. They're very good Minecraft players. And OC and Boba, they played this map a lot.
Boba's actually a bit of a ninja.
She's
you can see from those bow accuracy. That was very good. And OC is surprisingly capable.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's played this map, I think, potentially as much as or more than Pedgwin and Ravs. She really knows it. She knows where the spawners are. She knows how to do everything. Like, and also she's a cool cat. You know, she doesn't get moldy. She doesn't get angry. She's always chilled no matter the situation. So I really like playing with OC. I'm a big fan. Like, she's good.
Very chilled. Like, playing with OC every time. I think I was playing with her and she, I think she was on the other team and she was bringing the wool back over and over again. And every time she was like, oh no, they got me again.
Oh no, I'll do it again. You know, my 10-minute walk to get the wool again. Just doesn't care. She's just happy. She's just happy to be involved, Lewis. And I love that. I love that a lot.
I'm watching Ravs here with one HP. He went for the spawner, didn't get it. About 15 mobs spawned, took him to one hit point, and he slowly ground them all back down.
But also, he's been doing it with that extra damage. You know, he's got so much extra damage. Has he popped a Turtle Master potion, it looks like? He's resistant on a regen potion. He's
so this is Ravs is Berserker as well.
Yeah, he's really making good use of it.
And he is, because it really does keep you alive against these... Look at him now, as he's trying to take the spawner out, being knocked back all the time.
He's trying so hard.
He's going to have to take out... It's a lot of work Pedgwin's put on him to get this diamond key on his own.
But it's going to all pay off, Lewis. The fact that they're doing this whilst Pedgwin's also working on the boss. Actually, Pedgwin is in the boss right now. Oh my God, we've completely missed it. He's doing Captain Gok. He's nearly soloed it. Oh my God, Lewis.
What are we watching? This is such different games. They've so much better since the first Yogscast inaugural championship.
I've got the key. I'm going to go dump stuff back at base, and I'm going to open fire.
They are zooming through this game right now. Pedgwin is having a bit of trouble with the crew. The crew they are really hard. But he's got that messenger speed and that jump buff. He's just chilling. Careful, he needs to be careful of the cannons here, though. These cannons, if they fire, they did a lot of damage.
Well, they're pointing right at him.
Yeah, they really are. They're waiting. But Captain Gog's going to spawn. I mean, this is perfect timing from the red team. You've got the wall coming back. You've got the key. I love this. Like, and the blue team, they still got to do their dungeon. Ped's won it. Oh, no, it was me. Oh, my God. I thought it was 1 HP. Ped,
he's doing it very carefully.
His shield's broken. Oh, my God.
Oh. Fortunately, Gok was low enough.
I almost died.
That was close.
Because two more hits and he would have... He would have died, yeah.
Oh, my God. And this is perfect as well. You got the wall carrier, your messenger wall carrier. It's exactly how you want it. I love this. This is great play from red. It's quite interesting that actually now, because the blue team is kind of have to spend time defending. They can't really make much progress on their dungeon. So the red team can actually just stop, go to the base, spend the coins, get regeared, make diamond armor, like share out the swords. They completely control the pace of the game. Now they have the key and this wool.
Well, they know that the blue team just have to spend some time defending. So, yeah. I mean, they can't wait too long or else they're just going to lose all their infrastructure and everything and it's going to be a mess.
And I wonder if we're going to see Martin continue to just pick away at this dungeon. I'd like to see one blue member continue to try to make progress.
So we got Bree coming in to harass Pedgwin, and Pedgwin's actually boxing himself in because he doesn't want to have to fight this berserker on
his own. Yeah, this is scary. I wouldn't want to fight the berserker. Ped needs to be careful. Ped needs to be really careful.
Duped
he's
him.
Got no shield
he's
as well, Lewis.
Him.
And look at that speed. He's
running home.
Away.
I see. He's running back to his team.
Oh, that double jump.
Bree.
That messenger movement. Just so clutch.
So Pedgwin's going to go back and reinforce himself. Okay, and then they're going to push on this island. Meanwhile, the other side.
Yeah, it looks like they're pushing the blue players on this monument island. They're trying to get them out.
One of them are headed back to our base. Oh, it's Ben's just destroying our infrastructure.
Yep.
so that that way when we need to run back, we have a little bit more of a difficult.
I mean, he's on his own there at least.
Yeah,
so.
I was trying to ding him there, but it didn't work.
Yes, he's doing it. He's doing it. Oh my gosh!
This is such an annoying play. I love it. I love it. Love it. Love it. Love it.
Look,
love
it's all
it.
Gone. All that high ground.
But Lewis, the blue team aren't making any progress because of this. Like they're completely halted. You know, all four players outside the dungeon, no one's in there getting more loot, no one's in there getting the key, no one's in there getting the wool. And the red team kind of just get to decide how they want to tackle this.
It does feel like the choices that these guys are making are very time efficient. Mm. You know, Ben and Mango running either interference or distraction, destroying infrastructure, all of it is like ticking time. You know, Rav's got the key.
Yeah, he's just juggling in his inventory. That's the message. Pedgwin is nerd polling.
I'm not sure where they're going here.
Are we going to see a levitation playlist? I know Pedgwin dreams of making it happen. He hasn't got a shield.
He still hasn't rebuilt his shield. I mean, Boba nearly hit him then.
Boba? It's on Boba now.
It's very high now, though. Does Ped calculate this? Do you reckon Ped has spent time testing this? He's not even going to bother with the levitation play. He's just going to nerd poll as far as he can.
He's going to get as close as he can and then do it, I think. He might even go for just a jump into the elevator. On the blue team, they need to go to the top of the tower now.
They're not reacting.
Why are they not reacting?
Because there's red team harassment at the bottom there. Mango and Ravs and...
Ignore Mango and Ravs. They got the wool. The wool's... Pedgwin's nerd polling all the way over. They kill Ravs with the diamond key. They've got to go get that diamond key again now. This is good. Look at Boba. She's just keeping Bree alive. That's what she's doing, Liz. She's just hitting Bree, just keeping him alive.
This is what her job is, though. Here's Peddy straightened up his nerd pole. He's adjusting it. I'm not sure why. I think it's weaving. He's like sidestep weaving to...
is too late. Why are the blue team not sending someone up? They need someone up right now.
All right, Pedgwin's trying to get over again, so we need to climb up before he does this levitation bullshit.
Levitation.
He's going the whole way. Barry, he's found an exploit.
It's fine. He's gone too high. One second. Let me line him up.
All right. That's how far you're allowed, according to Barry.
That's how far you're allowed, sir.
All right. What's he doing now?
Yeah, he's built over the protective area, sir. That's as a ban. That's an instant ban for me, Lewis.
That's all right. He didn't realise. He wasn't looking. But look at this now. The whole team, blue team is here.
Lewis, this is such a waste of blue team's time.
I know all four of them are defending. They only need one person to defend this, but they've got like a team group. And Martin's levitating over to harass him. What
a play. Oh, my God. Martin.
Oh, no. No, he missed. Oh, disaster.
What a heroic play.
So we thought Ped was going to levitate himself over, but Martin went for the counter levitation.
I think Lewis, can you see his red teammates are trying to build a ladder up, it looks like.
So Ped's throwing his loot off the edge for them to spend. Heart. He's like, here's my gold coins. Take them.
Interesting play. I mean, I'm very confident that they can just leave Boba and maybe one other friend up here.
Oh, the great thing, of course, about Pedgwin's class is that you can jump these double blocks quite easily. So he can put the double block in, and then any time he can just choose to scale it.
Yeah, he hasn't got a shield, though, Lewis. Why has he not brought himself a shield?
Oh, my gosh. Boba, oh! He's got an arrow in him. He got hit.
He got hit, but he didn't get knocked back. How?
I don't know. I don't know how he managed
really
to dodge
that.
He
got really lucky there, Lewis. Oh. That would have been death.
Oh,
this is it.
How high is he gone? Is his plan now to just dive onto the monument?
I don't think he is.
Before they can kill him,
I'm concerned.
Well, because he just needs to get to. He doesn't need to actually like.
What's he doing? He's exposed. Oh my god, he's playing a really risky game, Lewis.
I think his plan is to just fall onto the monument with the wool, and they can't stop it, right?
I mean, he's going to need to make a bit of a run up, right? He needs a bit of speed to get that distance,
get that jump. You think?
It's Martin's going again. Look, Martin's doing it. Martin's built over. Martin's juggled over, Lewis.
Oh,
he levitated himself in. Martin's below.
Poor Pedgwin sees it and he's like scared. He's like, I'm going to have to make my
play. Pedgwin doesn't have a shield. Martin's nerpolling. This is...
Ped, get your levitation arrow on.
Do the levitation arrow. You've got to do the levitation arrow.
This is it. This is your last chance.
Oh, Martin is hunting him. Martin can just break the blocks beneath him.
Yeah, I don't think he realises quite how high
he is. But look, the red team, they've just finished laddering up. Ravs is up here now. it's a battle in the skies. Everyone is here. Red team have got people up on the Monument Island. Mango Heck clearing
shooting
it out.
Down Martin gets knocked off, but he survived.
We gotta go. Everybody's dying.
Martin needs to hold this right now. He can't. He needs to kill Ravs.
Boba fell off. She was trying to jump over. Ozzy fell off.
I killed Ozzy and
they're jumping.
No,
off.
Yeah, that's me. I'm knocking them off.
Blue team, we're trying to scramble to return, but
I'm stuck by myself.
Oh my
there we
god,
go. One off the edge.
Martin.
Hopefully two.
Martin,
off the edge.
Good luck. Oh, he goes. Oh,
this is it. Pedgun has to make a move well. Right now. Red team are back up though, Lus. Red team. Are...
But so what happened was Ped and Mango sort of reinforced this little choke point. And I think the idea, Barry, is that they're going to use this as a staging post for future wool delivery.
Yeah, I quite like this, but I'm concerned. This feels very easy for Blue to defend as well. You know, as a good aggressive position this is, and it makes it very dangerous. Actually, as well, Lus, it's worth noting that actually the red side is that side. Pedgun probably doesn't even need to get on. He just needs to, like, jump close. Do you know what I mean?
Yes, exactly. So he just needs to, like, that's why I was thinking levitation across and fall onto the monument. If you die, just before you die, you'll still deliver that wool.
Yeah.
But yeah, risk.
I mean, this is halted Blue team's progression completely. There's no one in the dungeon right now, Lewis. Nobody. Looks like maybe we've got OC flirting with the idea of going back in. Yeah, it looks like she might be sent back in by a team, but
Martin's levitating across again. What a brave boy coming in.
Shield. Someone give him a shield.
I got him.
Nice.
I just got to knock Ped off. That's all I got to do with the knockback axe.
Oh, he's falling down.
He's down and he's in there. He's got Ravs of the Berserker on him. He just wants to smack him, please.
He's taking Pedgwin down, though. Ped's low.
Martin.
Ped's on 7, 5.
Oh. Is
he
not?
Wow.
And behind Ben. Ben's clearing the monument again.
Goodbye, Boba.
Oh, Ben comes in and ambushes Ozzy again and Boba. Ozzy's off.
I think they can do this. I think this is their time to push. You got to push right now while Martin isn't up there. Well, they haven't got Bree.
They've got to levitate now. You've got to do it now.
You've got to do it now, yeah. Ben's completely distracted Boba. You've got to go now, Ped.
I'll tell you what, new strat. I'm going to come from behind them. If you think you can hold them up there, I'll run over and come up from their base.
Ah! I'm low on health.
He's not levitating just yet, so...
I'm low!
Does Ped not have a levitate arrow? Is this the issue here, do you think?
His team must have bought him one. Come on, right now. You've got to go now. Otherwise, what's his plan? Just jump? But you'll just die to full damage. You can't get the height.
Is anybody going up our elevator?
I'm going up the elevator right now, yeah.
Cool, I'm
going
to go up from behind them then.
I'm coming up now, Ped. It's time to fly.
Yeah, it's time to fly.
So he's actually just going to go for the jump?
He's actually just going to jump it?
I don't think you can make it. It's so far, Lewis. It's like 20 blocks.
It's like I don't think anyone's jumped that far in Minecraft ever.
He knows what levitation now.
Oh, he's levitation. He's doing
him.
It. He's
his
doing
team
it.
Is shooting him. Okay, needs to be careful not to levitate him too high. We've got a blue player back up there. Bree.
He's on the island. All he needs to do is get down.
Carefully does it.
Back. Yay, yeah, good job.
The webby plate.
That was nice.
Honestly, blue team did a valiant defense of that. I was impressed. I thought the red team were just going to slide that in super easily, but they managed to do it.
What? I've never seen the like. Barry,
it's been amazing. An incredible wool return, Lewis. It's a certainly unique tactic, isn't it?
That was amazing.
It's been some really high-level play.
I've got a little bit of info for you. I found out what the red team spent their obsidian coins on.
Ooh,
and
good.
It's a little bit of an explanation. I'm just watching Martin take Bree out. Take Ben out, sorry.
God, Martin is such a cool cat with that cape. I'm so jealous.
Blow up a little bit of void there. So red team spent their obsidian coin on the knockback boots, which stops them from getting knockback.
Interesting. Is that what Pebbles wearing when they were doing that?
That's what Pedgwin was using when he was on the tower, you see. And that's why when Boba hit him with the arrow, he didn't go flying off. Because we were worried about why that happened.
Yeah.
But it's a good explanation for it. Now, Martin...
I think Martin's going to deal with this.
He's going to take out this tower.
He's the miner, actually, so he's going to be pretty good. He's going to just probably spend a minute. And I think this is all worth it, right? You know, this. You can't let this thing exist. It's going to be a disaster for their team.
It's frustrating because it does bypass.
I've got to say, listen, this ladder is hilarious. This ladder is hilarious.
They put a lot of infrastructure, a lot of time and energy and gold coins into this. But...
yeah, this is not a cheap amount of concrete. Also, actually, quite a lot of money spent on ladders. Ladders aren't super cheap either.
Yeah, so I guess Martin's just going to take out the pole bit of it.
Yeah, he's had enough. I mean, Martin...
he's going to start taking it out bit by bit. He's going to take out the platform. My gosh, what a lot of work for
what a
hero. Explorer boy here.
He's fucking... He's going to TNT it.
Well, I mean, it's a smart move, I guess.
I like this. I like this a lot from Martin. Good play. Good play.
It's
going to
take a little bit of time.
But that's okay. Blue team are working on their dungeon mod. This is happening. And red team, remember, in the midst of all of that, Lewis, we got a little bit lost. But Ravs did lose the key. Ravs did die and he lost the key. So I think he's swimming back up. He's cleared the spawners, but it's going to take him a minute to just go get that key again. Actually, it looks like they've sent Pedgwin to go do that this time because he's the messenger. So I like that. You know, they've secured the key. And where do you reckon they're going to open? What do you think we're going to see today? A fire dungeon first or an ice dungeon first?
Well, I don't know. We'll see, won't we? I assume they're going to go straight on to their fire dungeon.
Yeah, and it's very quick, Lewis. This is a factor that people always forget about, is the fire dungeon, it's so speedy. You can do it in probably half the time of the ice dungeon. It doesn't give you as much loot, but it's so quick. And if they can really just accelerate, the blue team might not even have their gold wool done yet.
Yeah, we typically see more ice dungeons done than blue because it's slightly easier. But I think red feel like they're already ahead. They want to capitalize on the advantage. They want to quickly drop the key into the nearby dungeon and then immediately start progressing through it, getting that netherite gear and just leading them to this unstoppable advantage. You know, in Capture the Wool, you do need to spiral your advantage into a victory.
100%. And I wonder if this is Ravs coming to spend their obsidian coins, their two obsidian coins.
So are there still... because they're a boss ahead, remember?
They are,
Red,
yeah.
So they've got obsidian coins. Is there...
So they could purchase for two coins, they could buy some double HP, some shields, some sticky socks, or they could buy the Woolworths vouchers, which are very strong. They reduce the price of the normal shops by a third.
Very good for Ben.
Very good value for Ben.
Because he's going to be buying more of that TNT 100%. And hopefully using it. So Ben's blowing up infrastructure, but Martin is cleaning up the red team that are around the map.
Yeah.
And just putting a stop to this stuff. It looks like...
Martin's got TNT, and having the TNT jewel, I love it.
Yeah, I don't think Ben expected to see Martin put down a TNT, but there you go.
Ben puts down a TNT, blows up the bridge. It's a hilarious
fight. Then pins him on that island. This is what I was talking about. The idea of this pin is that, you know, now Martin's stuck there. There's no way he can get across.
No, he's got to build some kind of infrastructure or some kind of bridge, but it's difficult to do that when you're being shot by arrows. You know, it's tough.
It is really, really annoying. But Martin, there you go. He knows how to get the high ground on Ben, and he's just gonna. Hopefully, he thinks he can just kill him before, or at least drive him away, and just then like, give himself an opportunity to get up to this bit higher platform. There you go, and then he's across. Martin knows what he's doing.
Yeah,
also, he's not gonna let Ben harass him, is he?
That's good. That's good early infrastructure from the blue. I like building that high route because it's really hard and annoying for the red team to get around there and destroy that. That's probably gonna stay there the entire game, and that means they have a guaranteed route across to the central island.
Yeah, Rav's building a route to the central island here as well, realizing that the tower's gone, and so Rav's puts a little bit of time into infrastructure because they can. You know, they're sending one guy up to get the key. They can't really do anything until that happens.
Yeah.
So they should be working clear. Looks like they're going to go to the Fire Island, as we predicted, because they've already built some infrastructure over to there. They do need to clear out the spawners on this Fire Island, but I assume they will.
I think they've got someone going over.
Get around
that?
To that someone, eventually.
Someone's hanging out. Mango's hanging out over here. She'll probably go over there and do that.
Meanwhile, the blue team have got are working their way back up their dungeon. Three of them, they really got to move as a team. Martin is just the only one.
They are utilizing this shortcut, Lewis, this emerald shortcut that we now see in play. This quick little snipe through. It cuts out a lot of the dungeon and it makes that run back really quick. And I'm glad to see the blue team using it because it's going to make the difference.
Oof, Rav's left on two health there. As Martin not playing the Grenadier, but playing a very good Grenadier.
That is kind of the explorer's role. You've got the haste. You're good at blowing up these bridges. You're good at destroying these bridges with pickaxes. It is kind of your role to get rid of these bridges.
And honestly, Martin with that quick flint and steel use, actually kind of like working as a Grenadier might well be. Like
he's good at Minecraft, isn't he? There's no beat around the bush.
It's a real fiddle to like try and set those TNTs on fire before, you know.
He's making it look easy. Easy.
He is, isn't he? He's really got it. And he's already back and already harassing.
Ravs is so... Oh, the TNT. He's going for the TNT on Ravs. Look at this. This island, there's nothing going to be left of this island.
This is the problem, you see. Martin's got to switch to the TNT. He's got to ignite it. And Ravs is just breaking it.
Ravs can just break it before he ignites it.
Yeah.
This fight is hilarious. I feel like Martin needs to probably give up now, though, and go and help his team with this mushroom dungeon, because I don't think they're having a great time, Lewis. There's still three players on the top floor.
Oh, Ravs! No, he's shielding... Oh, he shielded it. Nice. Still alive. Ravs. Still alive.
Look at this island, Lewis. What's happened?
There's not much left of it.
A beautiful little jungle island. It's all gone. What the hell?
Well, I mean, you could conceivably just take out your opponent's entire island, couldn't you?
We have seen it happen. We've seen people level islands before, and there's a Grenadier in the game, and they might have bought the vouchers. So, you know what, Lewis? I'm not going to hold out hope.
I'm hoping for it. I'm looking forward to that. I want to see. I want to see an island deleted off the map, Barry.
Lewis, it looks like Pedgwin's got a friend. Pedgwin's recruited the llama, the alpaca.
Oh, onto red team side.
It's the little advantage you get. The slight advantage. Careful with the alpaca. Jeez, Ped. Careful.
A fifth no! team member.
He's got him.
Oh
he's
my god. It's all right.
Okay. Need to save Jeremy.
But this actually is kind of relevant. The alpaca spit does quite a lot of damage, and he can just keep it with him. And if it gets aggroed, mobs, you know, it will spit back at them and it will spit at players. So I like this.
He's trying to be careful though.
Get this alpaca up. Also, he's be careful with the lava.
Jeremy fell too far.
I put a sad face in the chat for that one, Lewis. That is a sad face from us
in the commentary box.
That is awful. That is the worst thing in the world. But there you go. Pedgwin's got the key. Fire dungeon's open, Lewis. It's looking bad for blue.
Rams, do you have ladders?
Yeah, I got a bunch of ladders. Here, I'll give you guys my ladders and I'll hold them at the entrance, okay?
Okay, cool. Sounds great. Thank you.
All right, Manga, let's do this puzzle.
The blue team, they've actually got the key out, though. OC's moving towards the ice dungeon.
So what he says here is Ben actually has trapped himself on this island, but it looks like what he's going to do is build himself a little fort.
Yeah.
And he's going to use it to stop them from rebuilding their way across.
I love this. Really annoying play from Ben. It's really good. Really, really good.
Yeah, he's going to wait until
fire dungeon, though.
This does rely on having a blue player die. Mm-hmm. Which might not happen.
They play carefully. I'm just concerned, Lewis. They haven't made any progress on this mushroom boss. They're really slipping behind now. This isn't good.
Well, there's two of them climbing, and Ozzy just died trying to clear her way to the ice dungeon.
That's another key loss for them, Lewis. This is all time. Precious
time. So Ozzy was trying to open the ice dungeon, but she was doing it on her own, and she got caught out, I think.
Yeah, this is not looking good for the blue team. Martin is running some good aggro, though, and it looks like the red team are having trouble. Maybe Pedgwin's trying to dictate to Mango how to do this puzzle. Because this is a slightly complicated puzzle. This isn't the easiest.
Oh, it feels like blue team are just taking more risks, though. Bree just died to a pillager in the gold dungeon.
I think they're panicking and they're rushing, Lewis, you know?
They're spreading themselves too thin.
Yeah. Martin with this jump into the water. Ben's bridge damage means nothing to Martin. Oh, Ben, you need to be careful now. Martin's annoyed.
Yeah, he's saying he's sieging them. He was hoping they would die, and they did. And now there's unfortunately so many of them.
Every time you kill Ben, he just blows up more. Look at that. Look how annoying that is. They're going to build a little bridge over that. All of this sucks for the blue team.
Bree doesn't even want to bother, like, bridging it. He's just jumping across like Martin. But that is such a dangerous game.
Lewis, Bree actually doesn't have any armor on. I hope he's realised that. He's armorless.
He's naked.
Not good in this game mode. You need to be wearing armor.
Let's tell him.
Bree,
put some clothes on. You're indecent.
give him a good talking to. Give him a stern talking to, Lewis.
It's indecent.
Fuck's sake. Looks like red team are slowly making progress on this first puzzle, Lewis. Pedgwin and Mango, they're doing good.
Fort Sharky, yeah. Fort Sharky didn't hold well.
Long.
Yeah,
no.
That's true.
We've got Martin going back in for this mushroom dungeon. Boba's with him. They got to finish this dungeon soon, Lewis, right?
Poor OC. I'm watching her. She sort of got to the bed exploded area and sort of sighed, looked at it. It's like, I'm building across again.
They have to be so sad right now. This is not fun for them. Ben is really, really causing some headaches. And, you know, it's simple. Just commit one player to just stopping him getting across in this deep. But he's going to do it again, Lewis. He's already over. OC's still bridging.
Well, you gotta keep your pecker up.
Oh my god, he's here and he's just got more TNT in hand. He's running over, lol, 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 lol. This grenadier
class. Is he just gonna run past OC again around this little edge bit?
Please, OC, come on, kill him. Oh, OC.
In he comes. He's switching to a weapon. Oh. And off she goes.
No,
oh,
she's on the black concrete bench. But Ben's just going past. He's going for the infrastructure again. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. It's brutal.
It's so annoying.
It's so annoying. This is so much time wasted. I mean, this is a lot of commitment from Red Team. You know, it's a lot of coins to buy all this TNT. It's not cheap, Lewis. And they didn't buy the voucher. So, you know, they're probably pumping a lot of money into Ben.
But you can understand,
right,
they're now fighting through the Diamond Dungeon. And the Diamond Dungeon coins are tradable for a lot of gold coins. So all he needs is his team to drop off a couple of diamond coins for him, and that is plenty of TNT.
And he's been quite conservative. You know, he's not spamming it. He's doing it just the odd single one to blow up the single wide bridges.
So what we have here is a great example of the Red Team, Ravs and Paired, working together to complete this puzzle. So this puzzle, if you didn't know, haven't really seen it before, Pedgwin can see the answer.
Yep.
because this is the safe route, but Ravs has to follow the safe route. And so Pegwin's above, telling Ravs where to go, and Ravs is looking up above him to see if he's stepping on the right bit.
You can see the little lights turn on just to guide Ravs as well. Yeah. And if he falls into this lava wither rose hell below.
Yeah, it is so that is
not good.
That is death.
And as he steps on the correct path, it turns into crying obsidian. So if he does slip, he can quickly, you know, get back to where he was.
Yeah, and so you know, you could slowly get the map.
But it looks like they've done it, and that's as he presses on the complete buzzle. Well, buzzle, of course, bleb language. Ped gets teleported down and they get another obsidian coinless, another one to the collection.
Wow, you get. I didn't know you got obsidian coins for completing these puzzles now.
Yes,
that's
another new change.
Good.
So it's worth noting there's only two puzzles in the fire dungeon, so you can only get two obsidian coins from doing the puzzles, but there are three puzzles in the ice dungeon, so there's three obsidian coins up for grabs, and it looks like they've nearly got the key overlord. They're about to open the ice dungeon.
We can still do it.
I think if we can get some decent enough stuff from in here, then we can start to level out.
I'm trying to get these spawners as well, and...
Yeah, there's the other spawner gun.
Nice.
Very Oh, sorry.
God!
I turn around and thought it was an enemy.
Surprise! I'm not the enemy. I may look like one because of my face.
It's the beauty of the monobrow that's so alluring.
Looks like, though, Luss, finally, Bree is at the top of the mushroom dungeon and he's into the boss. Finally, Luss. It's taken a while, but they're here. And, oh my God, if anyone's going to do it, I believe in Bree. Bree's done this boss before. He's a good player. He's got this unlock. Martin is doing his puzzle though, Luss, and he's making good progress. He's nearly completed it. But look how many slimes he's dealing with while he's trying to do this puzzle.
Well, it's a lot of gold. It's a lot of diamond coins though, and it adds up.
But he also, this is a hard puzzle. This has got four pistons on this puzzle, Luss, and he's trying to solo it. If Martin can solo this, I will be so impressed.
Well, if anyone can do it, it's Martin. We know that.
He's an absolute hero. Absolute hero. I'm concerned though, Luss. The red team are deep. They're deep in that fire dungeon. They're onto that fire puzzle.
They've already reached the second fire puzzle.
Yeah, and it's all going to be... The dungeon just unfolds from that point, and you can really zoom through it. It's going to be scary. Equally, we'll see the red fire dungeon boss, which we didn't see last video. So I'm excited for us to see how the teams tackle that.
Okay, I've got the obsidian books.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Which one of us shall carry the wool?
I'll carry it so that you can heal me if things go wrong, right?
I can't heal the wool carrier, so maybe I should carry it.
Oh, you can't?
No.
Oh.
Because you're technically on another team. It's okay. We can work with this.
That's so huge.
That's
so
good.
Important.
We needed it. I mean, blue team have been splitting their forces so widely.
Yeah.
We're watching one of them try and complete the puzzle on the final dungeon.
I mean, Lewis, this could be a disaster for the blue team, though. If the red team just stop doing the fire dungeon and come and defend... This is going to be, it's going to be a nightmare.
Yeah, but look, Ravs and Ped are so committed to doing this second puzzle.
They're deep
in the middle of it.
And you really don't want to stop now. This is, you know, you're inches from the end. You just want to get this done.
Mango's doing it with Ped.
Oh, I wonder if Ped, yeah. Is Ravs? Ravs is the one who's coming to defend for the red team.
All right, Ben, we should hold Middle Island.
Ooh. It's all to play for here. Ravs is potioning up. He's firing fireworks at Bree. These are strong. You need to be careful, Bree. Oh, I really want to see Boba going first. This is scary. Ravs is the berserker. You can't really just go up against him. Bree is also the berserker.
Oh, he hit both with a firework and another
so
one.
So much damage.
Go away.
She's tanking it with the shield, though. Good micro. Good micro from her. She has to push him just to keep Bree behind her. And Ben's here as well, though. Look at those fireworks going in. Ravs is just unloading.
Bree took a few hits because he's got skeletons behind him. He's trapped in a cobweb.
So low. He's dropping low.
Oh, Bree. Four health.
Wait, we need more blue team members to help secure
Bree's
this
having to run. He's having to run just from the mobs on this island, dropping him from these undestroyed spawners up to the top
ben
of these
blows
houses.
Up the bridge. That's the bridge gone. The blue team need to pull people out of the ice dungeon right now, Luss. They need to help.
Okay, so I've got the wool. I'm ready to go to the island.
Nice,
they've got two on there.
If you hold back, Bree, we're backing you up in the tree just a few seconds. I'm just going to try and get over to the island if I can. I've got one HP, though, so one arrow and I'm done for. In fact, any four damage and I'm done for. Right, I'm on the island. Careful. I'm behind them now, so I can hopefully do something.
We gotta kill him.
Oh, got shot in the back with another levitation arrow. And Bree's, he's put himself
Martin's
in his house in order to
Martin's
not get
going for the push
loaded.
On Ravs. Oh, Martin, be careful. Be careful.
Oh, he's down.
That sucks so much.
Ravs is on fire, but I think he just drank his health potion. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Put himself up at full health.
He loves that. And look, he's going to keep it out in his hand. He's going to be recharging it while they wait to push.
Ozzy's doing her best.
His invitation. He's coming over.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. He's flying up straight into that. This isn't good. Oh, no. This isn't good. Ravs, this is really bad. Bree must be panicking hard right now because he's the berserker.
He's got an axe out. But Bree's also the berserker, remember.
One elf or Bree.
Bree's got the
they took each other out.
That's so bad for the blue team, though, Lewis.
Ravs has got to be happy with that.
Yeah. I want to see blue team just forget about the diamond dungeon. Stop Ben destroying this infrastructure. Defend the island. Just like hold this down. It's unacceptable. You can't let this last any longer. You have to secure this wall right now. It's been too long.
Well, they've taken a risk. Then again, remember, it's in Capture the Wool, they could take the other wall. They could go straight to the fire dungeon and take that.
I really like that play, Lewis. I'm glad you said it because I think that's really what they should do. I'm concerned they don't know how deep Pedgrin and Mango are, though, because they need to move right now if they have any hope of stopping this progress.
That's true. But look, Pedgrin's getting injured. He's getting really injured to these wither skeletons and these blazes.
There's a lot of good chests in this room, and Pedgrin knows it.
He's got a lot of spawners to break, and he's breaking them. He's breaking them, but he's getting low.
Yeah, he's so speedy. Movement, just the mobility you get from this messenger class.
It's powerful to dodge those blaze shots as well. Because they don't hit that hard, those blaze shots. They catch on fire, but...
It's the combination of the fire with the wither that really ticks you down. Both the dots applied at the same time is really sketchy. Blue team looks like they were actually putting more work into defending the Monument Island this time, which is needed. It's really needed. We can't have a disaster like that again, Lewis. We got to bring this wool in. It's unacceptable.
Man, I'm impressed with this play. I'm impressed with the play today. I think after the Twitch rivals, these guys have really upped their game, haven't they?
Yeah, they really, really turned
so much quicker, like, in terms of, like, how quickly they've completed stuff, how quickly they can kill stuff.
It's so cute.
Their combat skills have improved. Boba's decided she's going to take the pink wall this time.
I've got it on my head.
I like this. Putting it, you know, allowing Bree to play a bit more liberally. You know, he gets to go forward a bit more and not be so concerned about dying. I really enjoy that. This is a good idea.
Well, that's the thing with the berserker. You know, you want to be low, but if you're the wool carrier,
you really don't want to be low.
You don't want to be low.
No. But like, also, I love this from Bree. He's just playing aggro and just slowing up Ravs and Ben so they don't have time to get to Monument Island and break these bridges.
Yeah, well, I think they finally learned that someone has to put a stop to Ben because he's not that strong as a combat.
No.
And if you just take him out as he goes around.
He's wearing full diamond armor now though. Well, I mean, that's vicious.
Oh, Ben.
I'm so glad we caught that. It's little treats like that, Lewis, that make Capture the Wool a dream to watch.
It is, isn't it? Little
nuggets,
mistakes.
Little nuggets of joy.
I can almost hear the facepalm.
You can. Fuck's sake. Pedgrin and Mango taking it slowly now. They're really looting up this top floor, and this is good because this is all
mine takes
stuff.
Out Ravs, which leaves Blue Team Boba a very, very straight path to the monument, actually.
Where's she at? She's in the water. She's still got a bit
she's
of dungeon
got a
to
while
swim
to go. Yeah, still got a bit of dungeon to swim through.
But I really
right.
like this. Bring all the Blue Team over. Let's not mess up
Martin,
this time.
Almost saved himself.
Ben getting a kill on Martin. Ben's got to be happy about that.
Ben's
got to
be happy, exactly. But he doesn't know Bree's coming. But Bree up!
What is it? What's what are you guys doing? Is there something in the air around here?
I assume he was going for a cheeky jump knockback, you know?
But I mean, they've kind of just allowed Ben into the island now. Who's on the island? You need to be defending. OC, make some plays. Let's go.
I'm just going to sneak in.
I mean, if we get a team wipe on just those two, we'll be all right, because it's literally a 4v2 situation.
If I just sneak in, it'll be fine.
Boba's in. Boba, be careful. Martin, protect her. Martin.
Oh, here comes Ravs. Ravs is just going straight on Boba. Boba's on fire. Ravs is hitting all. Ravs is all over Boba. This is a disaster.
There we go. He's gone.
But Ravs died. Boba's on 5 health, on fire, going up. She's going to make it. I think it's okay.
That is not what you want.
No, Ravs was really brutal. But Ben, coming up below. Martin, though, acting like a human shield, blocking these crossbow shots.
Knock him out. Nice. They're going to hunt him down. Boba looks like she's going to be pretty safe.
Looks like she's going to get that wool.
Oh, and I feel good. I feel good for the blue team.
Blue team are
going
to be pleased
wool.
By that, and they might feel that they have to go straight to the fire dungeon after this.
I would love to see that, because Lewis, the red team, Ped, he's already on this top floor. He's looting this Neverite. He's breaking these spawners. This is scary. Neverite is really, really strong.
There we go. Boba showing her strength there, taking that wool.
I guess a little clap for me. I'll get a little clap for that. Well done. Good work. Good teamwork.
We did it.
Woo-hoo. Maybe the best shout here would be if you two go and start harassing on the fire dungeon, even if it's just a case of like trying to hold them for a little bit partway up.
That's the only way I can think of slowing them down.
You know what? I'm just going to throw it all in and tell me what to keep, yeah?
Yeah, keep books, keep coins. Oh, and a city book. Don't mind if I do.
Well, the thing is, Pedgun has very limited inventory space, so he has to be combining loot down and sharing it with Mango, so that's why they're taking their time. They're spending a lot of time doing it, Lewis. And the blue team are back in the ice dungeon, well, trying to make progress.
I think it's worth it, though. I think it's worth just ensuring that they've got, like, they're as geared as they can be, because mm-hmm. when it comes to that fight, they need to win it.
Yep.
And if they win it, they've won the game.
Yep.
You know, if they take the first time they take the wall to the monument, they mm-hmm. want to win.
Yep.
Otherwise, what you can do is you can get into this dangerous situation where you give them a chance.
Mm-hmm.
And every time you have a team taking the wall to the monument, that's a chance for
it's
them
a risk.
To win.
You know, it's a risk. It's a time investment risk that yeah. you can really,
because all you need is a fight to go badly or something strange to happen or someone to get knocked off on that monument and suddenly you've lost the game. You know.
Yeah. I mean, I'm worried about this blue team doing this ice puzzle. I feel like red team has spent so long, Pedgun and Mango, slowly looting this fire dungeon. They could have made it overless. They really could have interrupted
it. But at the same time, they're getting obsidian coins, they're getting gold coins. They can spend those on gear, and they're getting geared themselves. Every puzzle they do gives them more loot in the catch-up than trying to fight over loot that's possibly already been taken.
And there we go. The puzzle's finally done. Congratulations to Martin. I mean, he was soloing that for so long. It was a real labor of love for him. So good job. And crucially, that is going to unlock diamond gear for the rest of their team, which, you know, Bree's not in diamond gear. OC is not in diamond gear. They need this direly. Looks like Mango and Pedgun are clearing out the spawners. They're taking this a little bit slower. They're not rushing through as much as Pedgun was earlier. Looks like they're clearing this. They're clearing all the mobs. You know, Pedgun wants to just do this properly, do it slowly, and not mess up. You don't. There's no point taking a risk when you've got this much of a lead, right?
There's been a lot less harassment today, actually. We've not seen, like...
Well, I mean, I don't know. Ben's, I'd say, ruined Blue's
game.
Well,
it's been kind of outdoor harassment rather than indoor, right? It's been very open world, kind of... It's been delaying harassment rather than, like, thieving, like theft.
Like Ravs and Ben have just spent like a minute just breaking every single bridge on the connecting to the ice diamond ice tower. This is, they're just spending so much time to just ruin this infrastructure. Blue team must be so angry about it, right? They can't be happy.
The funny thing is Ben always like seals himself off on these islands and then realizes, oh shit, I have to actually get off this.
I like to think that he thinks he's made a little home. You know, he can live inside the mushroom. There's a little house inside the mushroom. There you go. Look, he's having a great time.
Right. Oh, you're right. He has actually. He's obviously been through here before because he knows.
There's a little house in here.
He seems to know what he's doing.
He's mining a wall.
Well, but no. But he's going up on the roof because he knows he's built this nerd path back.
Oh my god, I love it. I love Ben's little adventure we've been watching today. Christy, actually, Boba, I think, is now in the fire dungeon. We've got a blue player being aggressive, and I like it. This is good. Maybe she can catch catch him on the drop on the boss or something. Martin was slayed by Ravs. Ravs is in the ice tower, Lewis. Ravs running aggro. He's bullying Bree and Martin, and Bree manages to hold. Hopefully they got all the loot out. Hopefully they need this diamond armor so dearly on that blue team.
Well, we got Ben about to run into Martin. Martin's bumming his way across, but... Martin just doesn't care about Ben's harassment, does he?
No, he's just done with it.
Oh, he thought Martin! He could make that jump, though. Oh, that's going to annoy him.
Oh, no. Ben's... Ben!
Ben was too close to...
I don't know what we are watching, Lewis,
well,
but it is fabulous.
It's
a fabulous play today. Pedgun, Mango, they're on the top floor, Lewis. They're looting the Neverite. They're probably going to make their gear into Neverite gear, and then we're going to see them onto this boss.
They're taking their time. They're really taking their sweet time.
I think it's fair. I like this. You know, don't want to miss anything. If you leave some Neverite for the other team, it's so, so bad. And I think Pedgrin's really having inventory management issues. You lose the far right hand five columns of your inventory.
It's really frustrating.
So bad.
Especially when you're trying to juggle a bow and potions and gear and all the fancy stuff.
Yeah, it's a really sad time. But having actually a lot of trouble with these little fire scarabs. They're doing all right. I love these little fire scarabs. Super cute.
I'm not sure what Ravs is trying to achieve here. He's just got himself killed. I'm really not sure what that was, but...
Bree's beginning to work on the next puzzle now, you know, uncontested because Ravs has beansed into the void. I wonder if these blue... Actually, Lewis, Boba and OC, the power duo, they're catching up. They're nearly going to catch Mango and Ped, and they're just busy making Neverite armor. If they can just open a chest and loot some armor or something, This would be so good right now.
But everyone knows you've played this enough that they know how this works.
Yeah, OC is very experienced.
I can't stop watching Ben, honestly. Ben's journeys in blowing up Martin's bridges. It's such a joy.
And the cobwebs as well.
Because that's an alternative strat, isn't it? You know, you just completely fog up their route.
I mean, they are committing an entire player to do this, remember? It's a lot. It's a lot.
Yeah, it's a lot.
I'm concerned about this this Mango Pedguin duo. Are they going to go for the boss? Are they just going to wait for the blue players below them to catch up and then kill them and then do the boss? I don't know what their strategy or idea is right now.
They're taking this gold. They're making the gold into...
Neverite ingots.
Neverite ingots.
And they've got this smithing table set up. So I think we're going to see this diamond armor
And then they're going to take their diamond armor straight up into Netherite.
Yeah. And it's...
I guess they spent a long time enchanting their diamond armor because the enchants stick through,
do
they?
The enchants carry through. Yeah. You know, Neverite's quite new. But a lot of people don't know what it does. It gives you, you know, obviously more armor, but actually it gives you a slight percentage of knockback resistance, which in this game mode, with the amount of void deaths and knockback kills you see... That tiny percentage can actually make all of the difference. So not just tankier.
Penguin has knockback boots from the obsidian coins anyway.
He does. Hopefully they're still in his inventory and they haven't just burnt away because they don't get much durability.
Maybe they've gone by now then, and that's why he's thinking maybe he will replace. Maybe it's worth replacing your boots with proper boots anyway.
Well, you can always just juggle switch. If you've got the wool, you suddenly put them on just as you're carrying it back. Penguin's a pretty accomplished player. I trust him.
Yeah, Boba and OC making their way through the dungeon, but unfortunately they don't know.
Ravs is coming.
Ravs behind them.
And we're going to if OC and Boba wipe here, we're going to see a three-man boss attempt, and Nameless Bleb is going to go down very quickly.
Yeah.
Boba breaking the infrastructure, saying, no, Ravs, you're not coming up. Go away.
Uh-oh.
Boba.
Go away, Boba. Ravs. Boba. Actively.
Careful.
You don't want to fight that berserker. Those berserkers one-on-one are really scary.
Full diamond armor as well, right? You are scared as a little cleric. I mean, this doesn't feel great. You're sending your cleric and your plague doctor to be aggressive.
Here comes OC. Like... 5 health OC, though. Oh, dead instantly. And Penguin comes in behind Boba.
Full Neverite is not a chance.
Oh, my gosh. He didn't even pause, did he? He just ran straight in. But the thing is, that messenger's the speed. I don't think Boba even knew he was there, but they coordinated that, didn't they? Ravs was like, come down and fight them.
Yeah.
And they did. They just turned around.
On the blue side, they've quickly made some progress on that second puzzle. Lewis, not taking as much time as the first one, and they're through. And that means they're going to get their enchanting chest. They would have a final puzzle to do for the Neverite, but they'll get some good loot. Bree and Martin making good progress, though. They're just running and gunning through this top floor corridor. It's really good work.
They're making this catch-up look really well, but actually I think
is this
the
last...
other boys
they're about to go in.
Yeah,
have we got it? Yeah,
they're about to go in.
Get ready to teleport.
Ravs is low, but
he's in
full Netherite. Ravs and Mango full Netherite.
Look at that. Look how intimidating that is.
Pedguin's Netherite trousers and everything else.
Here we go, they're going in. Get ready to teleport to Ravsy.
Bleb of the storm.
The Bleb of the Stormless, and now ignore the invisible gas that we can see, the players can't see that, but we have got the Bleb of the Storm. Inspired by Dark Souls 3 boss, this is quite the cool boss. I love this one, you know. You got a phantom with a Bleb riding it. Look at his magic weapon as well. Look how intimidating he is. He's got these circles that fire down lightning. There's lava, there's wither, this arena is hell. So they need to firstly just work on bringing down the Bleb of the Storm's mount, and then he'll land, and then he'll begin to duel them.
Well, they've already taken him to 40%. Look at this. They've shooting him very accurately.
And this is the power, though. They spent that time enchanting and using the books to make good bows. And that's going to make all the difference. Because, the damage is crazy, isn't it?
Yeah, just a couple of them shooting up is doing this. Mostly Ravs, actually.
That's the Phantom gone. Bleb of the Storm. The Clarence, he falls into the void and he'll reset.
Clarence, there he is. The Nameless Bleb.
He's coming. And he's a beefed up wither skeleton. He's not happy. They're doing well, though, to parkour around all these lightning AoE areas and get out of the Wither Rose bed. They're doing okay. They're doing good.
There we go.
Careful, Clarence.
He's chasing Mango.
Does Mango know? Mango doesn't know. Mango, be careful.
Mango, turn around.
He sets her on fire. She's withered as well.
Who is she looking at?
Mango. Mango's dropping low 3 HP. She's going to die to Fireless. You don't just turn your back on the Nameless Bleb.
Well, she didn't know he was there. I think she thought she was shooting this skeleton skull here, Barry.
Oh my god. And the lightning. Careful, careful, guys. Ped drop's actually quite low as well.
Ravs on 12.
Yeah, they need to be careful. You take so much tick damage because he sets you on fire. You get hit by the lightning. You get hit by the wither. Like, Ped is low as well. They need to be careful. Ravs
is getting him from the back there. Look at this. The team. Yeah, I warned you about the Pegwin Ravs team, didn't
they're
I?
Stepping on the Wither
didn't
Roses.
Didn't I?
You did. They're doing good.
If you're trying to solo this, this must be really hard.
I have done it a couple of times, and it is a real bull ache. Also, he just has a lot of HP. Look, they're hitting him with Neverite Enchanted Swords, and he's barely going down.
Look at the Messenger, though, being able to like hit and move back in time.
Come on, they nearly got this. Paired?
Sorry, I think Ped can take it. Their gear is so well equipped.
Also, Ped with just that double jump in this arena is so nice. There we go.
He's down.
He goes down. Obsidian coins up on the monument, and they get the wool as well.
Here it is, the final wool, the red wool.
I can't believe it, Lewis. While we've been watching that, guess what? Martin and Bree have completed the ice puzzle. They're getting Neverite.
Oh my god, they're actually still in it.
They actually caught up.
They have hardly any time.
They have no time, Lewis. They need to move right now.
They need
now.
To get this gear made so quick and get
back. And
that's
the message. Now they know. Pedgren's picked up the Red Bull. Grab the Neverite, suicide out, and go.
Boots.
There's a diamond pick in the chest on the top floor if you want that.
Oh no. They've got their wool. They got their wool.
Bringing the wool down.
Oh, okay. Stay at base because we're literally going to come back in like two seconds.
Yeah, well, let's go off and die then, right?
Yeah.
This is crucial timing. I can't believe they managed to make it though, Lewis.
Well, they're in such
believe.
A rush though, right? They really aren't. They don't have time to think. They just have to really quickly craft that netherite gear if they can.
Yeah, look at them. They're speedily trying to do it. They're checking chests, trying to find the gold. This is it. You need gold. They always forget this, but you need gold to make the netherite ingots. I wonder, do they have any?
I don't reckon they have any because it's provided in that final dungeon and you always forget it. This is what Ped and Mango had the luxury of doing. They had the luxury of time.
So you do loot some gold from the gold dungeon, but a lot of people don't loot it. Like a lot of people just leave it.
Like yeah.
And Lewis, this is all fresh time. Ped's halfway out.
About to go through the shortcut.
Yeah, the second puzzle on the shortcut, and they're nearly at the shortcut, and then they're just dropping down basically to the entrance.
Wow, this is really quick, isn't it?
This is really quick, and there's no one on the blue team looking anywhere at the main island.
Oh no, Ped fell in the lava!
Ed,
I'm okay,
alright. Okay.
He's actually going to be fine. Yeah.
They need to react. I'd see no blue team members, Lewis, on the main island.
I'll make somebody a chest plate real quick.
Okay, I'm going to make my own chest plate.
Oh, did I drop? Oh, no, there's one there.
Oh, here you go, Martin. I got some leggings. I've got three diamonds.
Do you only have time to do this, guys? They're walking out of the dungeon right now.
Oh, they're all four blue team are in their base. They don't know what they're doing.
There you go, Osi. There's some leggings.
Oh, amazing. Thank you.
How many netherite scraps have you got, Bri?
I don't know, but there's the ingots.
Blue players, come on!
And there's a straight route. Look, Ravs has built this
Martin's
straight
seen it.
Route.
Called it. Martin must have seen that. They're moving.
We gotta go like now.
This infrastructure, this investment of time from
and
Ravs.
Martin obviously never destroyed it. And they know exactly where to go. And Pegwin's running so fast.
I think they're too late. They're going to get a couple shots, but they need to move right now. Ravs is right behind them, the Berserker, full Neverite gear. He's going to be terrifying. They've got a path over.
They're
blue.
Miles away.
Where is
Ped's already halfway up. This is over.
No.
This is...
They're firing TNT arrows. Ravs is blowing up the infrastructure with TNT arrows. He's not going to let them through.
Ben's just knocking people out. Martin got knocked out of the world. There's TNT arrows. Oh my God, OC's dead. Boba's being pushed back by Ravs.
Ped's holding the shield, Lewis. It's not looking good.
Oh, look at that defense, though. That last minute infrastructure defense.
And that TNT arrow from Ravs. Just so clutch. So clutch to just destroy the bridges. And that's it. They should have just gone to defend, Lewis. But that's it. That's a wrap. Red team. Red team with the dub.
Second Yogscast inaugural race for the wall. Another victory for Pegwin.
And Ben.
Red team
and Ben.
And Ben too,
Big shout out to Ben.
No. Well done to Mango and Ravs as well. Yeah, being very important on
honestly,
their
Lewis,
team.
I cannot believe that near catch-up we had from the blue team. How did they move from
they
that ice tower
so
quick?
They worked so well on that ice dungeon. They really sped through that.
They were so far behind. Do you remember how far behind they were getting their gold dungeon wool out and them being in the fire tower?
And that gear level at the end was fine. But do you know what? It came down to that final push. They were too slow. They were too slow, and Ravs and Ben just messing with them as they came in.
Bree topping the kill loot scoreboard, so well played, Bree.
Great game. Really, I love this. We're gonna have to do some more of these. Thank you, Barry.
Thank you, Lewis. Thank you for commentating with me.
What a wonderful, what a great, gripping Capture the Wall.
GG.
Goodbye.